Do not plug this cable into your iPhone or this one into your Android. In the world of hacking, attackers are getting more and more clever with what they're doing. In the old days, we would plug in a device to capture keystrokes very easily, and those devices were bulky and clunky. We also had Wi-Fi access points that we could plug in real quick, but it was somewhat noticeable. OMG, a company that's supported by Hack5, or that works in conjunction with Hack5, and those are the folks that make a whole bunch of hacking tools for us pen testers, they came out with this bad boy. This looks just like an iPhone lightning charger. Inside of this end, though, there is a keylogger that will log up to 650,000 keystrokes.
Pow!
Oh!
They also have additions that come with, this just looks like a standard USB-C to C connection for maybe charging your Mac Pro keyboard, or maybe one of your Android phones. But both of the devices come with a Wi-Fi connection. Yeah, there's a Wi-Fi access point inside of the tip here. And what that does is, if I can get you to plug this into your phone, I will be able to gain remote access to your phone. And I can do things like take a picture with your own camera, take your photos off your phone, take your contacts, read your text messages. Anything you can do with your phone in your hand, I can do via this cable. So the learning here is that, one, we don't borrow cables from just anybody. We're very selective about that. We also don't use charging stations at conventions or at airports, because who placed the cable there? And would you be able to tell what kind of a cable it is? If you find a cable on the ground somewhere, I know they're expensive. Technically, they shouldn't be as expensive as they are. It used to be on the wholesale side of things, and it's stupid, the markup. But I get it. A normal cable is going to run you, what, 10, 15, 20, 25 bucks? And that's if you're lucky. So I get the need to want to find a cable and go, oh, I'm just going to use this. But please don't do this. This is a traditional attack vector that us hackers do, is I'll take this cable, I'll go to a targeted business or company, and I'll just drop it on the floor and see who picks it up. And as soon as they pick it up, I got to get into their device. And as an attacker, here's a real kicker for you. If I think you're on to me, it has a self-destruct option built into it, meaning it basically destroys all the components in it that make it this hacking cable. It then just becomes a charge cable. So now there is no evidence that I got into your system. Now, the other issue that you want to do is, as I mentioned before, when you're traveling, don't use those different charge stations that you might see out there, even the ones that are going to cost you a pretty penny. Always carry with you your own battery bank and your own AC adapters and your own cables. I'm not worried about buying cables like these at Best Buy or your local electronic stores. Those are going to be safe cables. But anytime somebody says, yeah, you can borrow this one, especially if it's from me, trust me, you don't want to borrow it. And it gets a little scarier. Here's another one for you from them. This is just a standard USB-C to standard USB-A adapter, right? You've seen these before. You haven't seen one like this. The same concept, has a key logger in it. And all these devices also support something called scripting, where I don't have to have a connection to you. You just plug it in, and because of that key logger that's built into it, it automatically runs a script for me to make a connection back to me and notifies me, hey, by the way, your phone is now available to me. Well, that's all for now. Dale here, just dumbing down what I know to help keep your family and mine just a little bit safer and smarter with all the tech that we use. Now, to learn more, check out the links below where we deep dive into what we've already learned. And by the way, you know the drill. If you'll hit that like button, comment, subscribe. See you next time.